Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Kim Weisskopf's unraveling of a grisly prescription. The House Call. Starring Jackie Cooper. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the makers of Hallmark Cards, Nabisco, Kodak, and the Ford Motor Company. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Doctors are a strange breed. They are scientists, craftsmen, and to a degree, heroes. Dr. Edward Goodley is about to take his surgeon's hands to a most unusual operation. We call it the House Call. Picture this. County General Hospital. A surgical team is going home after an all-night vigil.
I've been up all night, Pete. I'm exhausted. I got out of surgery not 15 minutes ago. The others will understand. My game would suffer, we'd lose, so you'd suffer.
Oh, but Eddie, you said yourself, golf is good therapy. Get out in the clean, fresh air. Stretch those tired muscles.
Paging Dr. Goodley. Paging Dr. Goodley.
I've got a call, Pete.
Make it snappy, will you? We got a 10 o'clock starting time.
Hello?
Hello, is this Dr. Goodley?
Yes, who's this?
Lynn Carpenter, you probably don't remember me.
Of course I remember. I wrote you a letter of recommendation for county health work.
Yeah.
Did you get the job?
Yes, thank you, but...
Is something the matter?
I don't know why I'm calling you. There's no one else. I can trust no one here.
Where are you calling from?
Shady Glade Rest Home. I work here. I think someone should know about conditions out here.
What do you mean?
Well, it has to do with how the old people are being treated. I can't say for sure, but from what patients have told me, and I think they're big.
Hello? Lynn? Hello?
Too tired to play golf, but some dizzy broad hangs up on you and you drive 100 miles out to the boondocks.
So, why did you come with me?
I've never been out here before.
I don't know. Lynn didn't hang up. She was cut off.
Why didn't you call her back?
I did. All circuits were busy. Or out. This is it.
Oh, it looks kind of crummy for a hospital.
It's not exactly a hospital. Shady Glade's a facility for the aged run by the county. They've had funding problems.
I guess so. You know, this place gives me the creeps.
Let's go in.
You're the doctor.
Pull the screen door shut, you will. The bugs are just horrible this time of year. I'm Mrs. Dixon, clinic supervisor. You would be...
Dr. Edward Goodley from County General. And this is Peter Lyons.
I'm in respirant fixtures.
How nice. What brings you gentlemen to Shady Glade? We rarely get visitors.
We're looking for someone, Mrs. Dixon.
Yes?
A young woman named Carpenter, Lynn Carpenter. I believe she works here. She called me on the phone earlier this morning.
Well, Lynn did work for us, but she left over a week ago. So she must have spoken to you from her new job. Though I have no idea who would hire the poor girl.
Why do you say that?
Oh, doctor, Lynn is a very sweet girl. But when it comes to working with the old and infirm, she's a total incompetent. We had to let her go.
I see. I thought she said she was calling from here, but I may have misunderstood.
Well, that must be the case, Dr. Goodley.
In any case, Mrs. Dixon, she did mention something about the way the patients were being treated here.
Oh, we have no patients here. We're all residents. The only privilege we have as administrators is the freedom to leave the grounds.
Lynn used the term old people.
Dr. Goodley, I cannot stand here and argue.
Surely, Mrs. Dixon, two parties are necessary for an argument, and I, for one, have not been a participant. If I had been, I would have called you a liar by this time.
Well?
I'm going over your head, all the way to County Superintendent McPhee. Don't bother to show us out. You'll be hearing from me.
the offices.
I'd like to speak with Superintendent McPhee. Tell him Ida Dixon is calling.
See Superintendent McPhee.
I'm sorry, but he isn't in.
When do you expect him back?
Not for the rest of the day. He had a meeting.
Oh. Well, let me leave a message for him. Tell him Dr. Goodley from County General was here. I have some urgent business to talk about. Ida, why didn't you tell me that you suspected the girl before all this happened?
I called you as soon as I knew. You're a hard man to reach.
Where's she now?
I had Percy take her out to the tool shed.
Goodley didn't see her?
I told you, he never left the room.
When did he leave?
Oh, 2 or 3 hours ago.
And what about this business of his coming to my office to see me?
He was just throwing his weight around, probably to ask you about the girl. All you have to do is back me up. There's nothing to worry about.
Well, let's hope so. Goodley has a reputation as a real bulldog. All right, take me to see the girl, and I'll be ready for Goodley.
Very well.
Now, here, let me take that off for you.
Oh, thank you. Oh, Dr. Goodley must have spoken to you. Mrs. Dixon and Percy locked me in here. Terrible things are happening. But please untie my hands. We have to get away.
There, dear. Are you going to be all right? I'm here to help you.
Oh, good.
You say that Mrs. Dixon and Percy did this?
Yes, and they've done worse to the others.
What others?
The old people here. There have been beatings and horrible, cruel things. I've been told and I've seen. Oh, Mrs. Dixon.
Yes, Giles?
This man
is County Superintendent McPhee. He knows all about your condition.
My condition?
Yes. Your fits and rantings. He's here to see that you are properly attended to.
Mrs. McPhee, she's lying. What I told you is the truth. You've got to believe me. Look, they bound my hands and hidden me out here so I couldn't be found.
Nonsense, child. You're a menace to the other residents. We have to keep you in isolation.
Please, Mr. McPhee, tell her to let me go. I've done nothing wrong. She's the one. And Percy, I've got proof.
You have? What proof?
Signed statements. Several of them.
Like this one?
Where did you get that? Give it to me. Mr. McPhee, read it for yourself.
May I see it, please? Well, these are strong allegations. Torture, starving. Perhaps this man, Mr. Singleton, is getting senile.
No! Oh, he's a fighter and sharp. Anyway, why would he lie?
Well, now, you say you had several other statements. Where would they be?
Untie my hands and I'll take you to them.
Well, that's a reasonable request.
No, Tom. She knows more than what I've told you.
You mean you...
I tried to help you, but you wouldn't let me.
Percy's going to her room now looking for the other papers. Mr. Singleton was smart enough to give me his by choice. Of course, there wasn't much of a choice. Oh, calm yourself, child.
Mrs. Dixon, I'd like to have a word with you.
Nearly there. Pete, did you notice the layout of Shady Glade when we were there this morning?
Well, let me think. We were in like a house. There was a smaller building off to one side and trees. Lots of trees. That's about all I remember. We left in such a rush. Wow, somebody else is leaving in a rush. Did you see that?
I saw it.
Hey, what are you doing?
Pulling over. We're going to walk in.
We're going to what?
We can go through here. Now, stay close to the trees.
And what do you expect to find out here anyway, Eddie?
I don't know. But I don't want to run into anyone while I'm looking, so stay down.
Hey, what's that? Did you hear that?
Look, over there.
Who's he? What's he doing?
I don't know. Let's get a closer look.
Well, what do you know? It's a stone forest. Boy, look at the size of that cemetery.
That's what I was afraid of.
What's that?
That man. He's digging a grave.
Ida, I found the papers.
Lucky for us.
Lucky for you and Percy, you mean. Can't have this kind of carelessness.
What do you mean, lucky for Percy and me? Why, you...
I'd like to scratch your eyes. No, you wouldn't.
I never should have listened to you in the first place. I take all the risks, and you sit back in your easy chair.
I am a public
servant. You're a devious, murdering...
Oh, slow down, slow down. You're very belligerent today, Ida. No need for us to fight. Not now. We got what we came for. Now, this girl has no family.
No, that's why we hired her. She rents this off-premises room from us, so no landlord's going to miss her. Same as the others. Percy's taking care of her. What about Dr. Goodley?
Leave him to me. You better be getting back to Shady Glade.
How do you propose I get there?
I'll call you a cab. Here's $20. That should cover it.
What about the other money? You owe me for 7 bodies.
Shed for a long time. I wonder who he buried in that grave.
I wonder who the second one's for.
Well, we can't stay here. It's getting late. And to tell you the truth, I'm a little tired of playing detective. Why don't we...
Pete, look out!
Huh?
Put down that shovel!
Who's going to make me?
Oh, my God, Eddie, he's nuts!
There's only one of him and 2 of us.
Come here, you...
Now!
Oh, I took a divot right out of his head. How's the girl?
She's in shock. We can't move her.
Someone's coming. It's a taxi. That Dixon woman's getting out. She's going into the main building.
You stay here. I'm going up to the house. Mrs. Dixon has some explaining to do. Mrs. Dixon? Mrs. Dixon? Somebody there?
In here.
What happened to you?
Percy, he did it. He drugged us all.
All right, take it easy, old-timer. Now, don't try to move.
The others, Alan Ward, except Singleton, he got away, too. I crawled this far.
Who's Singleton? Isn't there a doctor here?
There was. He's dead.
Mrs. Dixon, where is she? I saw her come in the building.
She's upstairs in the 3rd floor. She's the one who ordered this. She's the one.
It's going to be all right. I'm going to put you back into bed.
You ambulance boys made good time. There's a girl out in the tool shed who needs your help.
What about this woman?
Nothing you can do for her. Neck's broken. She's dead. My friend's with the girl now. He can help you. There are some people inside who'll need attention as well. The police should be here in a minute. I've got to get to town right away.
Who's there?
It's Dr. Goodley, Mr. McPhee. Could I see you a moment?
How'd you get into the building? It's closed for the night.
The guard let me in. I saw your light on. May I come in?
No, I was just leaving. I've paperwork to do at home.
But this won't take long.
I'm sorry. My duties come before a social visit.
This concerns your duties, and I'm not here to make small talk. I'm talking about complicity in a murder.
Sir, I have a car waiting.
A gray sedan with county license plates?
You're standing in my way.
Like the gray sedan that nearly ran me off the road this afternoon outside the Shady Glen rest home?
Where? Why, I don't believe I've been to Shady Glade since I took office.
You might be interested to know that Mrs. Dixon is dead.
The clinic supervisor dead?
She was pushed out of a 3rd-story window.
Are you accusing me of pushing her? That's preposterous.
No, you didn't push her. A man by the name of Singleton has already confessed that he did.
Singleton? We have no one on the staff payroll by that name.
But you have on the welfare roll. And I presume his government check is in that briefcase you're holding. You thought he'd been done away with like some of the others. With no next of kin, any number of Shady Glade residents could simply disappear with no questions asked. The government wouldn't know, would they?
This is absurd.
Then there's the matter of the missing Dr. Sherman.
What?
He's not missing anymore. His body's in a shallow, unmarked grave on the edge of the Shady Glade Cemetery.
Stand aside.
I'm not stopping you, but the police downstairs just might. It's all over, Mr. McPhee. Your duties and my visit. I just wanted to let you know.
Paging Dr. Goodley. Paging Dr. Goodley.
Lynn.
I wanted to thank you personally, Dr. Goodley, for saving my life and the lives of all those other people at Shady Glade.
It was you, young lady, who called for a doctor. And don't forget Pete. If it hadn't been for him, we might all be... Well, it all turned out for the best.
What's going to happen to Mr. Singleton?
They called Mrs. Dixon's death a justifiable homicide, so he'll get off.
Oh, good.
Percy won't be so fortunate, and Superintendent McPhee is going somewhere where he'll have a long time to grow old.
Mm-hmm.
I doubt that he'll do it gracefully.
Oh, I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
Come on in, Pete.
Well, just for a minute. I stopped by to remind you that we've got a 10 o'clock starting time tomorrow, so don't stay up all night tonight.
I won't if Lynn will join me for dinner.
Oh, I'd love to.
Oh, doctor.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
The House Call was adapted for radio by Kim Weisskopf. Jackie Cooper was heard as Dr. Goodley. Featured in the cast were Jerry Hausner, Ann Whitfield, Loreen Tuttle, Carl Swenson, and Alan Bergman. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.